Hello and welcome
to Scratch TV's Scratch Chat.
On this month's episode, we go to Comic-Con, Access to Music, Engineers Without Borders Society do Top Gear with us, and we have an interview with Be Chilled about promoting safe nightlife.
But first, we interview Joe Cooper and Richard Davies from the Extreme Sports Society.
Hi guys, thanks for coming into Scratch today and speaking to us. Can you briefly outline each of your roles and tell us how you got involved with the society?
I have an activities role, which is basically organising trips and activities.
My role is activities secretary, so I work under Joe to also organise activities. I got involved last year because I really wanted to do skydiving, and there was no skydiving society. So I messaged Ed, who was the president at the time, saying, I found this, and could we do this? And he was like, why don't you organise it? So he kind of took me on, and yeah, we did some skydiving last year, and we're now back doing more again this year, and a lot more. So that's how I kind of got involved.
Wicked. Can you tell us the most extreme thing you've done in the society?
So last week, I went extreme trampolining.
Nope.
Managed to gain myself this little injury of a broken finger. That was playing trampoline dodgeball. I think that's the most extreme thing I've done. But ski trip last year was also pretty intense.
Wicked.
For myself, probably skydiving with the society.
That's pretty extreme.
Yeah, that is very extreme.
First jump was a solo jump as well, so
okay.
Strapped to nobody. That was really, really good fun.
I see.
Before that though, before society, I'm a kayaker, so kayaking down a grade 5 waterfall was pretty intense.
How do people get involved with the society? And you know, you said your first jump was a solo jump. What training did you have to do, and how do you conduct training for the sports?
And then before the ski trip, we offer like snow dome trips and ACAs, which is a dry ski slope, so that people can learn if they're very beginners or just touch upon techniques. And the training is actually on the trip. You get put in lessons, so there's people who've done it before, like advanced people, so they basically just go in and they get like obviously just touch up their techniques. But if you're a complete beginner, don't worry about it. They teach you everything.
If we've got enough interest in anything, we'll try and organise it. You know,
if they really want to do something, say we've had a lot of interest for skate park and freestyle things like that. So as activities, I'm going to try and sort out. Like maybe a fortnightly trip to a skate park, just because that's what our members want, so ask and you shall receive.
They sound really fun, like everything you've mentioned I want to do, especially surfing, like, especially
yeah,
in the UK,
wicked.
Like.
Surf trip was awesome.
I can imagine. I said in the summer, I want to learn to surf by next summer. That was actually one of the aims
but you
I
can't
said.
Surf.
No?
Come in May.
By next summer.
By next summer, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, come in May. Yeah, I couldn't surf before I went on a trip.
Is it not a bit and cold?
What are your plans for the society going on into 2015?
Bigger, better, more sports, everything. Just going to go all out. Going to head into 2015 with a big bang. That's the plan.
Brilliant. Well, thanks for coming in to talk to us today, guys. The society sounds great fun. If people wanted to get involved, how would they go about getting involved with the society?
NESU directly, you can go in and pay. It's just £10 for our membership. And that doesn't cover trip costs, but all the trips are heavily subsidised, so you get it for the cheapest possible price. You can get membership online also, just on the SU website. And we have socials pretty much every week.
We also have a Facebook page as well, so you go on Facebook and search for b.e.s.t, BC Extreme Sports Team.
Thanks so
Brilliant.
Much,
Thank
guys.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Sandeep recently went to the Library of Birmingham to find out about the Bin It to Win It campaign.
Hi, I'm Sandeep and welcome to Scratch TV. Today I'm joined with Laddie, who is a project leader for his new project, Bin It to Win It. Could you explain how you came up with the idea and what it is?
So basically it was part of a competition with Birmingham Made Me, and they just literally told us, come up with an idea that has to do with sustainability and well-being, and we decided to tackle recycling. And most people know about recycling, but not a lot of people do it, so we thought, what if we give them money to do it? And obviously we cannot be handing out money every other day, so we created a lottery. So with every cup you recycle, you get to win a specific amount. So today we're working with £10, okay. And we're hoping with time, as it gets bigger, we get more people entering the lottery, we could take it up to £30. That's our target.
How do we do it?
So as you can see, there's a barcode there,
yeah.
And then that's a barcode scanner.
Yeah.
So it's a bit like your Tesco checkout, and you just have to keep trying and fiddling till you hear the awesome beep, and then you know you've got it. Yeah. So keep, that's
right,
it.
I heard it.
So then rip
this off.
Yeah, and that's why.
Place that in there.
So that's your number. What number is that?
What, 10,046?
Yeah, 10,046. So what you have to do is in the next two hours on our Twitter page and Facebook page, we would announce the winner and we'll be here with the money.
Excellent. I'm going to go ahead and do that now.
Sandeep is now here to interview Be Chilled, promoting harm reduction and safer nightlife across the city.
Hi Mark, welcome to Scratch TV.
Thank you very much for inviting me.
Tell us a bit about your project. How did it start?
And we felt that we needed to respond to meet the needs of people that were using legal highs. And we wanted to take a slightly different approach, which is why we felt it was really important for us to work within Birmingham's nighttime economy. So we work within the clubs and pubs around Birmingham city centre and around the Digbeth area. So we. And I have to say, the project wouldn't be as successful as it is without the volunteers. So we recruit volunteers, we give them relevant training around recreational drug use, and then the volunteers come out with us and we do that outreach work over night time.
Yes. So what are the precautions that you're telling students this year to do around Christmas time?
Well, it varies, and I mean, I could sit here and I could speak to you for the next half an hour about it, but what we've got, I brought in what we call our Save to Dance booklet, and we give these out free when we're doing our outreach sessions. Yeah. And what the booklet does, Sadiq, that it gives a range of advice from when you leave your house until you get back home. So there's some practical aspects about it. If you're going out with a group of friends, try and stay together. Try and leave maybe £10 close to home. So if you do lose your purse or your wallet, then you can get a taxi home safely. Then we've got the advice around drug use. And again, it's all in there. We've also produced some of these leaflets, and these have been designed by your design students at your university as well. Last year they done these for us, and we've got a range of these leaflets that cover legal highs, cannabis, MDMA, alcohol, and we've got some there as well around personal safety in the nighttime economy.
Brilliant.
But I suppose the overall message we're saying is that, you know, go out, have a great time, have a good time, use them in a safe way, and use them with people that you trust.
Yeah. Thank you for coming in today, Mark.
Oh, you're welcome.
Over to you, Lucinda and Deck.
Thanks, Sandy.
Hannah recently went to the Spotted Dog in Digbeth, where she interviewed various live musical acts that night for Access to Music.
I'm here at the Spotted Dog in Digbeth with Access to Music. Hi, I'm with Al Sam, Weasel Juice, Miles, Benj and Benji. Who would you say your music inspiration is?
Dave Grohl, Justice League, Led Zeppelin, Johnny Cash,
John Mayer,
Frank Sinatra, Dusty Springfield, Etta James, and recently Lana Del Rey.
How was the gig for you guys?
Basically,
very good.
We went on Google Maps and we found
Wicked. I loved it.
Right, with Prophecy.
Yeah.
It was good, yeah.
Oh, it was really nice actually. It was really interesting being here tonight, and I'm quite happy that I did the gig.
What is that I hear? Is it Deck the Halls? Right, now we're going to ask Deck a few questions testing his knowledge on the holiday. Can you name all of Santa's reindeers?
Rudolph.
Hmm?
Dancer.
Yep.
Dixon, is that one?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Prancer.
Yeah.
Vixen, have I said that?
Yeah. We're struggling.
No. Dasher, Dancer. Comet.
Yeah.
Have I got six?
Mm.
I think I'm going to have to. Have I said Rudolph?
I can't remember, but you still haven't got them all.
No, I'm not going to get... Is it two more?
Three more.
Comet?
You said that.
I can't
Are you going to give up? Do you want me to tell you?
Yeah.
Donna and Blitzen and Cupid.
Oh,
that's a shame. Next question is, who wrote A Christmas Carol?
Oh no.
Come on.
I do know it.
Go on then.
It's just not coming out. Oh no.
Are you passing on this as well, Dex?
I thought Christmas,
it's
I was
just
like...
It's Deck the Halls, but Deck doesn't seem to know any of the answers.
No.
Next.
No, hang on, is it Charles Dickens?
Yes, well yes. Done. Who wrote How the Grinch Stole Christmas?
Oh, it's not Dr. Seuss, is it?
It is, Deck, well done. Right, how many points does a snowflake have?
8.
No.
9.
6. Oh. Who played Ebenezer Scrooge in The Muppet Christmas Carol?
Oh, wow. I didn't watch it. And it's not. Is it Kermit's, like the evil bro?
I couldn't tell you, I just know the answer.
So is it not?
That's not the answer, no.
Oh.
The answer is, do you want the answer?
Yeah.
Michael Caine.
Oh.
Did you know that?
No, didn't have a clue.
Okay, question number 6. All I want for Christmas is what?
You.
Where does Santa Claus live?
North Pole.
Oh, come on, Lapland.
Is... Yeah,
isn't what it? Is oh. The name of the period leading up to Christmas?
Advent.
Yes, well done. Do you know what? I think you did so well, so you will get the prize.
Brilliant.
Here is your prize. Merry Christmas, Deck, a Hot Wheels car.
Thank you, Lucinda.
Have a lovely Christmas and let's deck the halls in the next Christmas. Wonderful. Next, Danny went to Comic-Con at the NEC. Let's check it out.
Recently, we collaborated with Engineers Without Borders Society to do our own version of Top Gear. Have a watch of the teaser here.
In a world where Engineers Without Borders meets Scratch TV, a race was born. One car. One train. One bike. One race. Who will win?
Now the full video can be seen online on our channel very soon.
You can let us know your thoughts about this month's episode by tweeting us at Scratch TV BCU or comment in the section below.
Like us on Facebook at Scratch TV to keep updated on all things BCU.
Bye! Bye.